Hey everybody, it's Connor, and today I want to talk about how to become an AI champion at work. So what do I mean by that? You have an opportunity here, because we are in such early days, to actually become a go-to person for AI and generative AI in your company. Why is that? Because as Pew Research will tell you, as The Verge will tell you, all this research says people are still not really using this, or they are not using this effectively. Generative AI, ChatGPT, things like that. You can be that person. Now, you might be thinking, well, I don't have a technical background. That does not matter. I'm telling you, all you need is natural language. I think you got that. You also need an intellectual curiosity. You need an ability to sort of say, I am actually going to go out and I'm going to learn this stuff. But here's the thing. It's really fun to do that with ChatGPT. I want to do something more systematic to try to figure out how we can become an AI champion at work in sort of something of a step-by-step process. So today we're going to learn a little bit about how to learn. You are going to sound super smart to your colleagues, but in a really authentic way in which you actually really do know what you're talking about. I think it's going to be pretty cool. Okay, so becoming an AI champion means you have to have your go-to sources. So I'm just going to give you three. You can find sources all over the internet. Maybe a subsequent video I'll tell you people to follow and how to find all that kind of information. But today I just want to show you three quick resources. So number one I love to go to is McKinsey.com. McKinsey's stuff is absolutely phenomenal. I go into Google and I look for McKinsey.com articles on AI. And here it is, artificial intelligence. You'll see that's by Quantum Black, which is a part of McKinsey. Click on that. And you'll see they have just amazing articles, insights into artificial intelligence, the economic potential of generative AI, the new productivity, et cetera, and then what every CEO should know about generative AI. Super easy to read, super clear, not a ton of jargon in there or anything like that. So I would absolutely go and check out this resource, number one. Okay, a second resource. And again, these are just mine. You'll find your own. This is an excellent one, The Verge. If you haven't heard of The Verge, go and check it out. Again, it's just all tech news. And it's a little bit more inside, but again, this is another great resource that you should check out. And the third one for today is TechCrunch. Again, if you haven't heard of TechCrunch, get on there, check it out. It has tons of cool stuff that everybody's going to be talking about who's in the know. This will set you apart from just the articles that everybody else is reading and, you know, on CNN or the New York Times or something like that. This is a level deeper than everybody else will be, I promise you. These are the kinds of cool things to check out. So I'm going to take the TechCrunch article as an example to use here with ChatGPT. Because here's the thing. This is not about becoming an AI champion the old way by just reading articles and trying to digest it and trying to remember what you learned and all that kind of stuff. We are going to use ChatGPT to teach us this stuff. So one, it's going to be way more efficient. And two, you're actually going to learn this. And so I'm going to show you what I mean by that. So let's head over here to ChatGPT and then go down to the plugins. Remember plugins? And we are going to click on, what's it called? It is called WebPilot. That is a phenomenal plugin. It does a ton, which I'm going to show you right now. So please read this article. Give me three bullet points to summarize and then offer five insights based on what you know about generative AI in 2023. I'm asking that to ChatGPT. And as you see, I posted that link to the TechCrunch article that we just saw. So ChatGPT is going to go in here and it's going to use the WebPilot thing. So it's using Python in the background. So here we go. So the summary, GitHub CEO stated at the Collision conference that AI, blah, 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 future where AI doesn't replace developers, but assists them. And democratization with tools like Copilot, software development becomes more easily accessible. Learning curve, the increasing acceptance rate of AI generated code suggestions over time indicates there's a learning curve. Even this, you kind of have to read in process. So we want to now think about the next step, right? So watch this. Wait, what's GitHub again? Because here's the point. There's going to be things where you just kind of hear and you're like, I think I'm supposed to know that, but you don't really know it. So let's ask. You can know, you can ask any dumb question you want. GitHub, web-based hosting service version, you know, control using Git. It's primarily used for computer code, SCM. What are you seeing here? If you really need to know what GitHub is, this is too complicated. Give me a simple non-tech example of what GitHub does. Sure, let's use the analogy of writing a book. Thank you, ChatGPT. Imagine you're writing a book with several other authors. You've been working on different... Now, you can read this yourself, but here's the key. When you might have heard about GitHub, everybody's talking about GitHub, stuff like that. This actually helps you remember in a very, very sticky way what GitHub is and what it does in making an analogy with books and different authors working on books. It's becoming sticky. You are now remembering things about something like GitHub, whereas in the past, you would have just glossed over and be like, GitHub, yeah, I know that's something like that. And you kind of know, but you don't totally know. That's what ChatGPT does, and that's the power of this. Okay, thanks, but now give me one simple sentence about the main point of the article. Not a summary, but something that a nice teacher might tell me to understand the point, right? So let's see what we come back with here. GitHub CEO is saying that artificial intelligence is becoming an essential tool for software developers, much like a helpful assistant, making their work easier and more efficient. What do we see here? I'll tell you what I see. That's too simple. Okay, so we went too simple on that. Okay. That's really simple. Give me something that will make me sound smart that I can say to a colleague. Considering the recent insights from GitHub CEO, it's evident that AI's, guys, you would never say this, right? You would never say this. So we say a little bit more simple, but that was good. Again, we're trying to get at just the right level of our learning. Based on what GitHub CEO recently said, AI is becoming a crucial part of software development. Tools like GitHub's Copilot are making coding easier and more accessible to everyone. And in the future, we might see 80% of code being written with AI's help. This could significantly boost the global economy, adding as much as $1.5 trillion by 2030. Folks, that to me is the Goldilocks moment. I am going to remember that, and now I know more about GitHub. And how long have we taken? We've taken about 4 minutes to learn what GitHub is, to learn how it's impacting, you know, the universe of AI, and also to have something smart to say to a colleague. But more importantly, authentically, we're actually learning. This is how we become an AI champion. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed that demo. You know how corporations have a learning culture? We have to have a learning culture. We have to keep up our intellectual curiosity to keep on learning about this stuff if we want to be that AI champion. And here's the really important part. Learning is different now. I hope you're starting to get that. You can ask all our dumb questions to ChatGPT, and it is not going to judge us. It's not just about sounding smart. It's about authentically learning this stuff so we can really put it into our heads and hold it there and retain it. And I don't know, I say we do more of this. So if you like this video, please subscribe. If you like what we do here, please share it with somebody else. See you next time.